Today I'm going to show you the features and benefits of our containment system. You're going to also learn how to install it, how to design it, and also the components of it. So one of the first things you're going to want to do is design your containment system. One of the hardest ones to design for is what we call a city skyline, pictured here. Multiple height cabinets, multiple depths, multiple widths, it resembles a city skyline. First and foremost, where you're going to put the main extrusion piece. So are you going to suspend it from the ceiling? Are you going to put it off the top of your tallest cabinet? Or are you going to support it by another structure? So the beauty about this whole system is very simplistic parts. We have about 9 pieces that can build an entire containment structure for you. And you have the flexibility on site that if you come across an unforeseen problem, trade, something like that, you can make decisions on the fly to readjust. Really, the only critical measurements that we need are the length of your containment row, the height of your containment row, what's your tallest cabinet, what's your shortest cabinet, what that height is going to be about the average, and the width of it. Do you have a 3-foot wide aisle? Do you have a 4-foot wide aisle? Those are our most crucial measurements. The reason being is we want to give you enough material in your pack to make sure that you can finish your containment structure. So now you've done your design work, you've ordered the product, it's now shipping to you in a pallet look like just like this. Depending on the size of your containment system, you can get multiple pallets. Now one thing to note is that you will get a door system in a separate pallet looking just like this pallet. So now we're going to open up the pallet and take a closer look at the components that we've shipped you. So what you'll notice packed in every pack is instruction manual, as well as you'll see your extrusions, your corners. Let's see, we've got some gussets right here and your joiners. So now you have your containment pack on site and you're going to get ready to build your containment structure. In your design section, you will design the containment structure with these basic components. So you'll have your main extrusion, your corner gusset, your polycarbonate panel, your screws, your clips, wiper gasket, and joiner. So the main extrusion, or universal channel as we call it, is the most brilliant piece of the entire containment system. You will notice that you can anchor to all 4 sides of the universal channel. What makes it brilliant is these ribs right inside the channel on all 4 sides. Those ribs make it the channel one long nut, the entire length of the extrusion channel. That allows you to put a screw in anywhere along this channel. That is in a CPI exclusive, which no other manufacturer currently has. So you'll notice on the universal channel that you have an offset below and above when you mount your channel. What that allows you to do is that allows you to go up with polycarbonate and down in the same foot marking. So what no longer matters is how tall your cabinets are, how many cabinets you have, at what height. You set your channel and you can take your polycarbonate panel and clip it in this way or that way. So when clipping your polycarbonate panel in, it is as simple as sliding it in using the clip with, you'll see these teeth mark. As you can see, I'm putting it into the channel. I'm pushing up and pressing in at the same time, and that's going to keep my panel solid in the channel. Now, if you had one coming out the other side as well, you can put one clip this way and one clip that way, handling going down or up on your extrusion. So the polycarbonate panel that you will receive in your package has exceeded all the smoke rating for plenum spaces. The NFPA has governed this year that the containment structure you are about to build is not a plenum space. As you can see, it's flexible. You can cut it very easy with a razor knife or X-Acto knife. You have the flutes for strength, so you'll be cutting across them or you'll be cutting with them. A lot easier to cut with them. You can score in between the flutes, snap it, score the other side just like you were cutting drywall. So the entire containment structure is put together by one type of screw. You don't have to drop in nuts. You don't have to do any of that. The channel is the nut itself. And the great thing about the entire system is this is a 3/8 nut. That is a perfect setup for 3/8 thread all rod coming down from the ceiling, coming up from your cabinets, any of that stuff. So when we ship you an extrusion piece, the longest we can ship you is 96 inches long. What if you have to make one longer? Or what if you have a cut piece that you need to make, you need to put two pieces together and make them longer? What we would do is your joiner. So your joiner piece slides right into the extrusion, like so. You screw it down on one side and join your other piece together. And now you have one long section. So you're going to start building your containment structure. One of the main components is this corner gusseted bracket. This corner gusseted bracket helps you structure all of the containment system in many different ways. It has holes ready to accept your 3/8 thread all rod or your screw. It has easy tabs, so it will find its way into our channel, and I'll demonstrate that now. So to make the first corner of your structure, you bring two of our main extrusions together, 90 degrees. You're going to use your corner gusset. Your tabs will find the channel. And then you'll take your two screws, one on one side, one on the other side. Screw them down and you'll have your first corner. So we'll ship you a ball gasket, and the ball gasket goes up against your polycarbonate panel. So if you can see in here, you have little teeth which will grab hold of your polycarbonate panel. So you can slide your polycarbonate panel on, and this ball gasket will press up against any other surface that you need to. So one thing we've added to the kit to make it look nice is when you have a corner and you've made your 90, you've got kind of a blunt end right there. What we want to do is we're going to give you a corner to dress that end up. So what you'll do is you put it on your corner, screw your two screws through there, and it'll make a corner which previously looked unfinished. It will look finished. So the door assembly in our hot aisle containment structure shown here comes in three pieces. You have the doors, you have the back wall, and you have the valance. Our doors are probably the single most used feature of your containment system over the life of the system. So we spent a lot of time in engineering these doors. There's a few key features you're going to want to pay attention to. First, it's a single hand open. There's a detent on the door, so when you open the door, it will stay open. Then, single hand close as well. So you can just close the door and walk away. It will close itself. Now, a nice little hidden feature, because we do everything high quality here at Chatsworth, is there's a metal strip with a magnet in the door to keep that door closed, to keep that airflow inside this containment structure. So one of the first things you're going to do is decide how you're going to mount your first channel. Your first channel, are you going to mount it above your cabinet? Are you going to mount it to the cabinet? Or are you going to mount it above the cabinet, attaching to the cabinet? That's the first main thing that you want to understand, is how you're going to maintain your first rail. You can mount it above the cabinet, still supported to the cabinet, or you can 3/8 thread all rod down, coming from the ceiling and supporting it that way. So if you have your city skyline, if I had another cabinet short of this, I can still make my containment panel go up and go down and block that section off perfectly. In this case, we're going to go right to the cabinet because we have all the same size cabinets, and all we need to do is put all polycarbonate panels going straight up to the ceiling. So on your chop saw or your miter box saw, you want to choose a blade made specifically to cut metal, as many teeth as you can get it. As you see here, we have chosen a 52 tooth blade specifically for cutting metal. So we're here in our showroom. We've gone over components, we've gone over cutting, we've gone over design, and now we're ready to assemble our containment structure. We've got it laid out here. We've got our gusset pieces, our main extrusion piece, and our screws. And that's all we need to do. So now all we need to do is assemble this. We're going to do it on the ground for display purposes. What you would normally do is take your main structure, your main piece, and mount that either to the top of the cabinet, or if you're hanging it from a thread all rod from the ceiling, you'd be doing that. So you'd put your main structure up first and then start building your corners around it. We're going to do it here on the ground so you can get a good bird's eye view of what's really going on. So we're going to start screwing our containment structure together. As you can see, we have our gussets, and our gussets are going to go on our main extrusion. What you want to make sure is that your gusset is placed so this is flat and flush, because your polycarbonate panel is going to come down and rest right on that little edge. If you flip this around, as you can see, it's going to bump into your polycarbonate panel. Not necessarily wrong, but it's better and smoother if you do it so it's all flush. Then all you need to do is put your screws in when we start building our corner. So now you're going to repeat the process for each corner. You're going to basically build a picture frame. We now have our one frame built. As you see, we've got our four corners in and what I refer to as a picture frame, because now you've built the frame and we can put our polycarbonate in. We can measure our polycarbonate from end to end and top to top. If you notice, we have a little extra lip on either side. So you can technically be about a quarter of an inch off on either side, so a half inch in your cut on your polycarbonate panel, and it would not affect the performance. You can use this as a full height blank filler panel if you wanted. If you had a cabinet or two cabinets next to each other with a space in the middle, all you'd have to do is put this in between and put your polycarbonate panel in, and you've got a full height filler panel. We're now joining the two frames to make our corner of our containment structure. We've added four of these gussets on our frame, and we're going to add two, one down the bottom, one on the top, to make our corner come together. And we want to make our corner look nice on the outside. So we're going to take our fascia piece and mount it. Now, when you set yourself up to use this fascia piece, you've got to be cautious on making sure you have the right spacing. So as you can see, I didn't butt my two picture frames up next to each other. I left the space so that these holes will line up perfectly with the channel. To review, we have cut all of our extrusions, we've installed all of our gussets, and our outside fascia corner. The next step is to cut the polycarbonate panels and to clip them in so that we contain our hot air or our cold air in our containment structure. So to cut the polycarbonate, I'm only using a box knife or a razor knife and a drywall square. I lay it over the top of it, use my razor knife and slice it down. Now going across the flutes is going to be a little bit more difficult than if you go with the flutes. With the flutes, all you have to do is score it on one side. You can snap it and score the other side. Here you have to cut completely through the flutes in order to get the piece off that you need. So a tool update. We have a new tool that we can provide you in a single pack or a 10 pack. It will help cutting the polycarbonate panel be a little easier. So if you notice on this tool, it has two cutting surfaces, one here and one here. You can cut one side of the polycarbonate or two sides at the same time. Remember, a key feature to our extrusion is that you can put polycarbonate panels going up towards the ceiling or down towards your cabinets on the same extrusion. If this was my extrusion coming across my cabinet, I would put my two clips in place, and then I would put a third clip in place going down to secure my polycarbonate panel. So your containment structure is here and your ceiling is here. If you were just to put your polycarbonate panel, you wouldn't have a nice seal against your ceiling. So we have this ball gasket that slips right over the polycarbonate, and you would cut your polycarbonate a little bit longer than you need to, so you get a little bit of depression on your ball seal. Remember, a key feature is to have polycarbonate panels going up towards your ceiling and down towards your cabinets. And if you come across an obstruction, you can just notch out your polycarbonate panels, or if you have a cabinet that are different heights, you can cut this polycarbonate panel and you're not cutting your extrusion again. The final step of the installation is you cut your polycarbonate panels and clip it in. All these sides are square, level, and even. Let's say you had a data center that was a city skyline. And remember, a city skyline, all different height cabinets. If you had that issue in your data center, you can use this ball seal on the end of your polycarbonate up against a lower cabinet. So you can cut your polycarbonate down a few inches, put your ball seal, and you get a nice seal. You can also do it to a side of a cabinet. Or you can take two ball seals, press them together on two polycarbonate panels, and they would not break apart. Now your installation might require hanging from a ceiling. In our demo here, we decided to go off the top of the cabinets. If you're going off your ceiling, you're going to use your ceiling bracket. Your ceiling bracket is going to attach to the side channel, and you're going to take your 3/8 thread all rod and come down and attach it to the ceiling. So I'm glad you've chosen Chatsworth Products hot aisle or cold aisle containment structure. And as you can see, minimal amount of parts for maximum amount of flexibility. Thank you. For more information, visit us at chatsworth.com or call our technical support.